everybody, this is Robert Dempsey of Dempsey Marketing, and joining me today is Sheila Duncan, co-creator of Trouble the Dog. Sheila, how are you today?
I'm great. Thank you so much for interviewing me, Robert. I really appreciate this.
I'm very, very looking forward to hearing your story. So let's get to that story, actually.
It's a story.
Excellent. So let's start off kind of in the beginning of what led you to co-creating Trouble the Dog.
Well, what happened was in 2006, by 2006, my niece was 12, my niece Kendra was 12, and she had lost her grandmother, who was my mother, her Nani, who was her best buddy, her dad, and also my dog, who was her best friend, Irish, the Golden Retriever, all to cancer within about a year. It was really tough for a kid. It's 12 years old is a tough age anyway, which you will see. And so one night are you familiar with the St. Jude Telethon, Robert? Okay. So I had the St. Jude Telethon on my television by mistake, and we were sitting in my TV room, and she noticed the children with cancer, and she hopped up and she said, "Oh, I've got to help these kids." So she sat down at my coffee table. She went, "Whoop." She drew a little dog with a black ring around his eye. She named him Trouble. And to fast forward, we worked together to turn him into a little symbol of hope for kids if they were going through a tough time. You know, if they were afraid or their parents were being divorced or they were ill, kids would just grab this dog and hang on to him. So we turned him into a children's book and had all sorts of help along the way. Had a major toy licensor who was friendly with a neighbor of mine down the street. He helped me connect with a toy manufacturer in China because he said, "I don't want to have anything to do with a dog named Trouble." And then he said, after I talked to him, he said, "You know, I think you've got something here." So it's been that type of momentum. It's been one of those things where when one door closes, which is great for entrepreneurs to know, when a door smashes into your face, another door will open if you just pay attention and just keep putting one foot in front of the other. So now we have a children's book, a plush dog, we have some jewelry, and we have magical, miraculous stories about Trouble's interaction with children.
Can you tell one of those stories?
I can absolutely tell you one. I was at a nail salon one day, and a woman sat next to me who I didn't remember, and she said, "Are you the Trouble lady?" I said, "Yeah, that's me." So she said, "I need to tell you, we bought a Trouble for my four-year-old grandson. He would not let anybody touch his Trouble dog. He slept with him, ate with him, talked to him. No one could hold him. No one could touch Trouble. His little cousin lost her dad." Now, no one's talking to this four-year-old about what's happening, okay? But kids absorb, you know, what's going on, what people are talking about. His little cousin came for the weekend. This boy ran to the door when she arrived, opened the door, took his Trouble dog, and put it into her arms. So I get stories like this. There's a little spirit going on in Trouble the Dog. Kids recognize it. And I could sit here for 3 days and tell you stories about animals, too, with Trouble the Dog. So it's amazing. Yeah, it amazes even me.
That this dog could be such a symbol and a kind of a stone, if you will, you know, for them to really hold themselves up against in times of trouble. That's awesome. So how
– Thank you.
I mean, how – when you – So you had the idea, right? You had the drawing, and you started off.
That's all I had was the drawing and the name.
And so what? Now you said you ultimately, right? You had the plush doll, a book, jewelry, and other items. So what was the first thing that you kind of the first roadblock, I guess, that you had to overcome? Was it getting the dog, the actual plush dog made?
Well, the first roadblock that I had to overcome was when I met through my neighbor who so believed in Trouble. You know, that's sort of what propelled me in the beginning. I knew I liked the look of the dog, but it was people's reactions to the dog that kept, when I would have a bad day, I would hear a story like the one I just told you, that kept propelling me. The first major roadblock I had, we had little pieces of jewelry made up, and children would rub the jewelry, you know, like a worry stone to make them feel better. I took the jewelry and I took a little coloring book that we had made, and I went to visit this toy licensor. And my first he was my first roadblock, basically saying, I don't want to have anything to do with a dog named Trouble. So going into that meeting, I knew he didn't like the concept, but I was determined to tell him a little bit more. And as I say, when I was done with that, he said, I think you've got something here. And he said, you know what, Sheila? I'm going to hold your hand every step of the way. And he took me upstairs into his huge factory. And he introduced me to people, his staff who helped me. I didn't know anything about having plush dogs made in China. Are you kidding? And without his help, the people in China who were wonderful once they realized that I was on the up and up and that I could answer their questions, but I could only do that because of this gentleman's belief in me, and it was because I so believed in myself, you see. That was it's because I knew in my heart that it was the right thing to do, and I think that's a big thing for entrepreneurs. If you know in your gut that what you're doing is right, then you'll keep going and you won't get disappointed. I believe me, I have had many, many disappointments. But if you know in your heart that it's right, then you'll keep going.
So here's a question. Obviously, the story behind Trouble the Dog really got to the toy manufacturer and helped propel everything forward.
Not in the beginning, though, believe me. It was when he took a minute to look at it. And he even knew the story before I went into the meeting, and he was not moved.
Mm-mm. Okay.
I think it was my passion that moved him.
Yeah, so your passion plus the story and your passion behind the story really kind of overcame, you know, it allowed him to really take a good look at it. Now, with kids, though, when they get the dog, I'm sure they don't see your passion. They don't see, you know, they might not necessarily hear, or if they hear, they might not understand the story if they're younger. Right. But it just seems to really capture them, you know.
It captures them. And, you know, we even did I had a gentleman who's a scientific researcher. And what he did was he did a survey to try to capture what was happening, and he said that it's almost like Trouble is almost like an equation for hope and love and joy for kids. They just get it, whether it's the drawing or whether it's the little spirit or whatever it is, they get it immediately. There's no, why is this dog named Trouble? I almost can't explain it. There's a little divine inspiration going on here that's way bigger than me. I'm just a middle-aged marblehead woman back here in Massachusetts, trying to keep up with it. That's what I am.
No, but that's such a fantastic story, and
thank you.
And I mean, it's great to. Yeah, some things you just can't explain. It just clicks, and you just go with it, right? I mean, what the heck?
Right, right. And, you know, I want to tell you, too, that now this has been going on since 2006, so I don't want people to think it's one of those things where my niece drew a dog and, you know, magically it's a miraculous success. I don't want to portray that at all, because it's been a really tough road, and you know, lots of going to schools and libraries and craft fairs and all this kind of stuff. But right now, I just came back right before Christmas. I had a meeting out in LA. We're meeting with some TV production companies, TV networks, because my ultimate goal is to turn Trouble into a cartoon that can help kids, however it's going to happen, that can just help kids all over the world know that, you know, everything's going to be okay.
Fantastic. And
Thank
so,
you.
I mean, and so really getting the word out up until this point has been, as you said, a lot of kind of boots on the ground, talking with people, showing the dog, telling the
Yes.
story, telling the
Yep.
stories behind the dog and
Right.
whatnot, and just going out there and meeting people.
Absolutely. And it's pretty much been just me, you know. And as I said, there are only so many fairs and schools and everything that you can go to. And that's why I so appreciate meeting you, because I don't think Trouble's been to Thailand yet.
Well, trouble is definitely invited to Thailand anytime.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, Sheila, as you said, this wasn't an overnight thing. It was a lot of work on your part over the
Yes.
years. You had to learn a lot of things also. So for all of our fellow entrepreneurs watching this video and listening to your story, what would you say are maybe one or two kind of overarching lessons that you could share from your years of experience?
Well, the first thing I would say is that I have to share with you that I came from a background. We had a family restaurant back here in the Boston area that we were basically forced to sell, you know, due to the economy. And it had been opened in 1946, so that was a real blow. So I had to figure out something else to do. Trouble just came, sort of magically came along, but I had to. I guess what I would say to other entrepreneurs is that if you, which I said earlier, you have to have a passion for what you're doing, because you'll be doing it at 6 in the morning, you'll be doing it at midnight. So you have to love what you do. Even though it's hard work, it can't feel like work. It has to feel more like a passion. That's the first thing I would say. And the second thing I would say, because I had to learn this. I didn't know anything about. I don't have children. I just have my niece. So I didn't know anything about plush dogs or children's books or graphic design or anything. So I had to depend on, you know, the wonderful people that I met. I had to depend on help from all sorts of different angles. But I guess the biggest thing that I had to depend on was myself, because people advise you, and it may feel like good advice at the time, but you still need to get quiet with yourself and make sure that's the direction that your gut is telling you that you need to take. And I'll give you an example. I had a meeting maybe 2 summers ago with a gentleman who basically said to me, "Sheila, you know, Trouble's cute, but the networks don't need you, okay? Maybe you want to have greeting cards made up or something, but believe me, Sheila, they don't need you." And you know, it was a very tough meeting. And at the end of the meeting, he said, "Maybe you need a website or something." So I left that meeting, had a really bad weekend, because this guy was very connected. And then I thought to myself, if this gentleman is trying to squash this little entity who I know is meant to be out there and hasn't looked at my website, then I need to override what he has said to me. I need to slog on, which has been a couple of years since he said it. And you know what? At some point, when Trouble is a cartoon and he's being shown in Thailand, then maybe I can send this gentleman an email and just say, "I had to follow my dream because I knew it was the right thing to do." So that would be my advice to entrepreneurs. If you know that what you're doing is right, then it will work. A few prayers don't help, don't hurt either. There's a lot of praying going on too.
Right. Well, Sheila, definitely keep us up to date on the
Well.
status of the movie, and if it comes out, definitely we'll have to come and do another interview.
Please. Oh, but it would be my pleasure. I absolutely will.
It's been great. Well, hey, thanks for all your time today and sharing your story. It's truly inspirational. I greatly appreciate it.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much, Robert. And I hope people will come and visit our website. Is it okay to give a link to the website or
Yeah,
no?
no, absolutely. Please. Again.
Okay, it's www.troubledog.net or www.troublesaysbetough.com, and people can see what Trouble looks like and see some of the stories, and you know, just get a clue to, yes, you can do it. You just have to be tough and hang in there.
Fantastic. Well, thanks again, Sheila. Have a great one.
Thank you.
All right, bye-bye.
Thank you.